కారణం వందే పన్నగ భూషణం శశిధరం వందే పశూనాంపతి వందే సూర్య శశాంక వల్లినయనం వందే ముకుంద ప్రియం వందే భక్తజనాశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే భక్తజన ఆశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే శివం శంకరం. ఫ్రెండ్స్, జ్ఞానయోగ ఈజ్ టు బి అండర్స్టూడ్, అబ్జార్బ్డ్, అసిమిలేటెడ్ అండ్ వీ షుడ్ బికమ్ జ్ఞానీస్. ఇట్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ హౌ ది టీచర్ ప్రెజెంట్స్ ది హోల్ కాన్సెప్ట్. ది ఐడియల్ టీచర్ ఇన్ అవర్ కంట్రీ ఈజ్ వ్యాస మహర్షి. హీ హ్యాస్ స్పెషలైజ్డ్ ఇన్ ది ఆర్ట్ ఆఫ్ టీచింగ్. The word Rishi itself is to denote a researcher. In our country, there were researchers in every field of study, in every walk of life. Dhanvantari did research in medical science. Narada Maharshi did research in emotional science. Vasishtha Maharshi did research in spiritual science. We have rishis in every walk of life, in every field of study. One such great rishi is Vyasa Maharshi, the global teacher, the best researcher. What the researcher finds is to be given to the society. A rishi is a combination of two things: one, research; other, teaching. Vyasa Maharshi is the best teacher and he has done research in teaching techniques, teaching methodologies. He is Jagadguru, Lokaguru, Nityaguru, Satyaguru, Shashwataguru. He is the master. He wanted to educate the mankind. Therefore, we consider him to be the Adarsha Guru, ideal teacher. His birthday is in the month of Ashada. The Purnami coming in that Ashada Masa, Adi Purnami. He is supposed to be the birthday of Vyasa Maharshi. Even today, we celebrate his birthday as Guru Purnima, Teacher's Day. What is this speciality of his teaching techniques? A good teacher gives the point first, principle first, and then he explains it. Three, he elaborates it. Four, he illustrates it. Four stages of teaching. First, E is equal to MC square. Only one student in the class will catch. The bright student, Sir C.V. Raman, would understand the meaning of E is equal to MC square. A physicist, a scientist, a bright student. But how about the remaining 39 students in the classroom? They require explanation. E stands for energy. M stands for mass. And then major lot may understand. Then you have to elaborate it further. You in detail give the explanation. Finally, you give an illustration, an example. Vyasa Maharshi followed this teaching technique. He gave the principle of yoga and then he explained it. Third, he elaborated it. For he illustrated it. We find yoga in Brahma Sutras in the form of a principle is equal to MC square. Abhava Brahma Jinyasa. Who will understand it? Then he explained it by compiling the Upanishadic literature, 108 of them. And then he brought Bhagavad Gita. For the majority of the students, there is a person called Krishna, there is a person called Arjuna, there is a conversation between these two people. Arjuna is dull, Arjuna is depressed, Arjuna is in stress, Arjuna is in a state of anxiety. He says, I am unable to hold the bow and arrow. I do not want to fight the battle. I want to run away from the battlefield. Please excuse me, Krishna. Every person passes through this state of depression, a state of escapism, a state of running away from the action. Then he came to illustration. Three stages. Brahma Sutra stage, a principle. Upanishadic stage, explanation. Bhagavad Gita stage, elaboration. And then he came to illustration. Is Bhagavad Gita a part of Mahabharata? Or is Mahabharata written to give the illustration of Bhagavad Gita? Yoga at four levels. In principle form, in explained form, in elaborated form, and in illustrated form. We know here in yoga instructor's course that there are four streams of yoga. By this time, we are all familiar with the four streams of yoga. We have Raja Yoga, royal, kingly, princely, majestic, magnificent, mighty. The willpower we do have, if it is strengthened, we become Raja Yogis. Yoga strengthens our willpower. However much you explain, we cannot understand. Vyasa Maharshi therefore creates a character in Mahabharata. See Bhishma, how royal, how determined, what a strong willpower. He decided not to marry and he remained unmarried throughout. We decide to wake up at 4 o'clock and we wake up at 8 o'clock. Determination must be strong. That willpower is embodied, personified, illustrated, exemplified, shown as a model in the character Bhishma. You find Brahma Sutras explaining Raja Yoga. We don't understand. We find Brahma Sutras given in or the principle of Raja Yoga in the Upanishads. We do not catch. In Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna explains we do not understand Raja Yoga a chapter. But when we look at the character of Bhishma, wonderful! How determined he is! How terrible he is! What an amount of strong willpower he has! So, an illustration, an example, a model will clear the picture. However much I describe gulab jam, rosy, a little brownish, the upper layer is a little thick, inside it is loose, soft, tender, and there is juice around it. However much you explain, elaborate it, we do not understand. Bring gulab jam, put it in the mouth, this is gulab jam. We understand. Vyasa Maharshi follows the technique of teaching, first the principle, next the explanation, third the elaboration, fourth illustration. For Raja Yoga, he followed all the techniques and he was not satisfied. Then he created the wonderful character Bhishma, always strong, very much of strong will, firmness, determination, stubborn, shall be like Mount Himalayas. And next, he wanted to explain Jnana Yoga. He created Ganga. What an amount of wisdom she has. Symbolic of Jnana is Ganga. He wanted to explain Bhakti Yoga. Another woman character, he created Kunti Devi. What an amount of devotion she has. He created the character of Satyavati for Karma Yoga. She has done nothing for herself, everything for the welfare of mankind. Everything for the welfare of Hastinapur. Everything for the family, say, for the society's sake, Karma Yoga. And you have next Draupadi for Sharanagati. Anyatha Sharanam Nasti Tvameva Sharanam Mama. To understand Raja Yoga, you look at Bhishma. To understand Jnana Yoga, you look at Ganga. To understand Bhakti, you look at Kunti. You look at Satyavati to understand Karma Yoga, and you look at Draupadi for total surrender, Sharanagati, Prapatti. Vyasa is a master. Now Jnana Yoga we have been reciting, we have been talking about, and some idea has been formed. Now we shall look at the character of Ganga. Once upon a time in this country, there was a city called Hastinapur, a kingdom called Hastinapur. And in that kingdom, in that city, there was a king called Mahabhishu. He was very kind, very compassionate, very, very affectionate. He loved his citizens. Therefore, he established hospitals, started schools and colleges, free education, free food, and free medical aid, roads were laid, chowdhuries were constructed, everything was at the disposal of the society, a nice king, a good king, and therefore the government of the cosmos, the universal government, wherein Amaravati or heaven is the capital, Delhi, the king of Amaravati, God's kingdom, Indra, on the advice of the Saptarshis jury, decided to give Bharata Ratna to this king. When anybody does any service good to the society, the government of India will select him for Bharata Ratna, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Padma Sri, etc. This Mahabhishu, the king of Hastinapur, was chosen for Bharata Ratna that year. Indra sent the letter, Mr. Mahabhishu, this year on the Republic Day, you are chosen for the award of Bharata Ratna. You will be given up and down air travel to come from the earth to the heaven, from Bangalore, from Hastinapur to Delhi. You can go back freely, you can come stay in Rashtrapati Bhavan, you will be taken care of. Mahabhishu was very, very happy to get the award. On the appointed day, he boarded the aircraft, reached Amaravati Swargar, Delhi, and then he was given the accommodation in Rashtrapati Bhavan, the special, spacious hall and the adjoining bedroom, etc., a suit for his stay. On the function, day of function, morning 10 o'clock, the King of Kings came and he gave the award. That evening, in honor of all the recipients, there was a dance performance. And in the dance performance, Bharatanatyam was to be displayed. And after the Bharatanatyam, there would be a dinner. This is what is followed in Delhi even today. Mahabhishu went, received the award. Evening, 5 o'clock, there is a beautiful amphitheater like the cricket stadium. In the middle, there was the stage, and Rambha, Urvasi, Menaka, Tilottama, Gataji, heavenly women, angels came to start their dance performance in Bharatanatyam. Mahavishnu was given a beautiful place. He was looking at the angels. They started with the usual steps. Mahavishnu was the master of dance. He had seen sufficient dance performances in India. Even after going to Delhi only Bharatanatyam, even after going to America only Bharatanatyam, he did not like it. Therefore, when the lesson is not liked by the student, same yoga, 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 every day when you speak, you get bored. When you get bored, what will you do? You use the mobile, receive the message, send the message. If that is not possible, take a pen and paper, draw the picture of the speaker. This is how the students engage themselves. If that is also not possible, mobile is sealed, paper is not allowed, you cannot sit, you cannot sleep, then what is to be done? There is the ladies' wing. You look at the girls. There is the boys' wing. You look at the boys. Bharatanatyam was not to the liking of Mahavishnu. Therefore, in that amphitheater, so many people were there. First time he went from Bangalore to Delhi, from earth to heaven, and there were so many heavenly girls, American girls, British girls, foreign girls, Delhi girls, UP girls, Bihari girls, and therefore he started looking at the girl one after the other, one after the other, one after the other. And he was not satisfied with one. Finally, he came to a particular girl, very beautiful, very attractive. Finished. He stopped the movement, he stopped the camera, no more movement, it became still photography. The girl was Ganga. She was also fed up every day function, Bharatanatyam, local girl. She was fed up, she was looking at the boys' wing, the gents' wing, men's wing. And in her survey of the visitors, she turned, and the fellow was found to be looking at her. Who is this fellow looking at me? After 2 minutes, she had the curiosity to look at the fellow. Is he looking at me still? She slowly looked at the fellow. Is looking. Next, she placed the palm under her chin, widened the fingers, looked at the fellow. He looked at me. Then Ganga thought, anyhow, someday I have to marry some idiot. Instead of marrying a person whom I love, it is better to marry a person who loves me. This fellow is after all a king and he got a Bharatanatra. Why can't I exchange my looks? She to look, he to look, she to look, he to look. Whoever loves, that love not first. And this was seen by Saptarshis, they were angry. In the YAC class, when the yoga is going on, how is it, how dare you look at girls, how dare you look at boys? Brahmachari Abdul Kalam got angry. Vasishtha Vishwamitra got angry. Indra, he was called. Prime Minister Modi is angry. Ask that fellow to get out. Indra stood up. Mr. Mahavishnu, get out. What mistake have you committed, sir? You looked at her. Sir, my air ticket is only tomorrow, sir. Nothing doing. Security, come here. Push him out. Not necessarily I am going. He was pushed out from the heaven to the earth. He rolled and fell on the earth. Mahavishnu. Because of the shock, he forgot who he was. That Mahavishnu is born as Shantanu Maharaj, the father of Bhishma. Now what happened to Ganga? While going, he looked at her. Critically, sorrowfully, because of you I am going. I am dismissed from the YAC course. I am asked to get out, I am given the DC. Ganga was looking at that man. Indra looked at Ganga. You are also responsible for the boy's misbehavior. You also get up. She stood up. Get out, he said. Thank you, sir. Who is in your classroom boring? Get out is not a punishment to students. They are very happy to get out of the class. When you ask them to get out, very good, thank you, she said and went. She went to the local railway station, bought the ticket by the Tatkal reservation from Delhi, from heaven to the earth. She traveled by AC two-tier coach from Delhi. On the way, in Nagpur railway station, she came out in between heaven and earth. She came out and 8 young men came and fell at her feet, 8 vasus, asta vasus. Ma, we came to know that you fell in love with a man. Yes. We came to know that you are going to marry him. Yes. Ma'am, we went to Vasishtha Maharshi's ashram. He cursed us to be born on the earth because we tried to steal his kamadeva. Please permit us to be born as your children. Kill us. We will fulfill the curse. We will have the redemption. We will come back to the heaven. Yes, she said. She came to the earth, looked at Shantanu, and he loved her. She loved him. Shantanu does not remember anything. Ganga remembers everything. Shantanu does not know the truth. Ganga knows the truth. She knows who she is. She knows who Shantanu is. She knows where she came from. She knows everything. Shantanu does not know anything. The fact here that I am trying to drive home here is Shantanu is like every one of us, ignorant man. Ganga is an enlightened girl. Awareness, consciousness, knows the truth. She has the knowledge, jnana. Ajnani is Shantanu, jnani is Ganga. Therefore she is fearless. Therefore she is confident. Therefore she is very sober. Mr. Shantanu, do you want to marry me? Yes. But I don't cook. I will go to club. I will be free. Yes, yes. All the conditions are written down. They went to the registrar's office. They got married. She is free, happy, cheerful, confident, fearless, energetic, because she knows the truth. Shantanu is miserable, pathetic, sorrowful, anxiety-ridden, stressed, because she does not know who, he does not know who she is. Few days, marriage was over, and the first baby was born. Ganga took that baby and put him in the river. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. She knows they are all vasus. 8th child is born. Shantanu stopped her. No more love do I have for you. Honey is dripping. Moon is fading. I want the boy. Mister, you have stopped me. I don't want to live with you, but the mother has the right to carry the child with her until he becomes the major. I shall get him educated. That boy is Devavrata. Ganga took that boy to heaven, got him educated under Narada Maharshi, under Vasishtha Maharshi, under Vishwamitra Maharshi, under Brihaspati, under Oxford University, Cambridge University, Western Universities, and made him a scholar, very good archer. When the boy was 16, he was brought back. She delivered the baby, made him a strong man. A jnani does everything perfectly. Now you have two characters. Ganga is always fearless, smiling, cheerful, active, beautiful. Shantanu, miserable, sorrowful, always anxiety ridden. He is ignorant. He has forgotten who he is. He does not know the truth. That he was Mahavishnu. That Ganga was there in the heaven. That the 8 children are vasus. He does not know anything. When you know the truth, you are careful, you are confident. Now, that same Devavrata has become Bhishma. Ganga is a symbolic of wisdom. Lord Shiva has Ganga on the head. that means he is wise. That means he knows the truth. That means he has the knowledge of Satya. Blessed are the people who are jnanis. Blessed are the people who know the truth. Bhagavad Gita, Krishna tells at the end, Arjun, there is only one difference between you. You do not know who you are. I know who I am. You do not know who I am. I know who I am, who you are, your past, your present, your future, my past, my present, my future. I know everything. Jnani I am. Therefore I am ever smiling. You are like jnani. You are an illusion. You are a person without the knowledge of the truth. Therefore you are miserable. The entire Bhagavad Gita is to highlight the benefits of knowledge. Jnana. Ganga is the symbol of wisdom. Knowledge, truth, satyam, nityam, anantam, satyam, jnanam, anantam, anandam, advitiyam, akhandam, achalam, adbhutam. May we all, by the grace of God Almighty, understand the spirit of truth, knowledge of truth, jnana, and be absorbed in that wisdom, total awareness, complete consciousness. Let us merge with the truth and enjoy our sojourn on this earth. Let us enjoy our journey on this earth. Let us not feel miserable. Confidence, fearlessness, cheerfulness, serenity, calmness, consciousness, awareness, all are benefits by simply knowing the truth. Ganga is a Jnana Ganga. Let us meditate on Sri Krishna, who is a Jnani.